Hard Drive.
2021 Chevy Corvette.
Convertible with Z51 package and, of course, lock control. Damn, that hooked up. Let's keep going. Keep going.
Horsepower and torque.
495 horsepower, 470 pound-feet of torque from a naturally aspirated 6.2 liter V8. And now that we're on our home turf, this is the first time that we actually get to send this through cliche corner. So let's see what happens if I turn in with these. Oh, this squircle's very weird, but man, this thing understeers at first, and then it just wants to oversteer. And we did drive this previously in Las Vegas. We drove it around the roads there. We drove this around the track there, and it did understeer there as well. But it's still a very fun experience, and this is the first time that we're actually driving the convertible.
So before we get into all the cool convertible stuff, which makes this convertible version much better than the hardtop version, we got to introduce today's sponsor, Omaze.
Remember last time when we offered you guys a chance to win a 2020 Land Rover Defender 110 First Edition and $20,000? Well, Jasmine from Brooklyn, New York won.
This time we're offering you the chance to win a super rare Corvette Stingray C8. Taxes and shipping are included for US residents, and even better, every donation benefits a great cause, the 500 Festival.
The 500 Festival Foundation generates funds in support of the 500 Festival's mission to produce life-enriching events and programs, fostering a positive impact on the city of Indianapolis and the state of Indiana. Your generosity can help the foundation in the advancement of the 500 Festival's youth programs and initiatives to provide access to underserved communities. You know, I've actually been to the Indy 500. Actually for NASCAR.
Did you win?
No, I didn't.
Dang. All you have to do is go to omaze.com/TSP and enter for your chance to win. And there is an early bird prize if you enter between May 10th and June 22nd, where you can win the ultimate VIP experience at the 2022 Indy 500 for you and a friend. So like we said from the Omaze callout, these cars are very rare, and especially in a convertible and in this yellow color.
Yeah, you can't actually buy any of these new. They're all sold out for, I'm pretty sure, like the next 2 years brand new.
Which is the best reason to visit omaze.com/TSP. But okay, this one in this color, it is so nice seeing it around, and in this convertible version, I think the convertible looks better than the hardtop.
It does have better lines out back because of the convertibleness, and I mean, we have the top down, and it's so easy to do. You just press a button. You don't have to like remove panels, put them in the front or the trunk.
Because the hardtop version, you can take the top off and hide that in the front, but this, we can't see the engine.
Yeah, so that part kind of sucks.
But does it really? Because I don't mind not looking at the engine to have a top that comes up and down all the time.
Yeah, I like seeing the engine if it's special.
But it looks even better with these big speedster kind of humps behind the driver and passenger too.
I get that.
And then it's also like kind of like a floating roof design because there's a black line. Like, I feel like there are no negative things about the convertible.
And you can also get this with like a black top and stuff like that, but I think body color is the way to go.
And then we are going to be comparing this against a similar Porsche, I guess, in the comments below. That's gonna come out in a few weeks. But like, having this right now in 2021 is like the most amazing thing.
It attracts so much attention. Like, everybody stares at this thing. Everybody wants to talk to you. It's nuts. It's like you're driving a supercar.
Okay, usually the Prowler gets the most attention. This gets as much attention for once.
It gets more.
I think this would get more attention than a Ferrari right now as well.
Right now. And the thing is, whenever you see these in red, I always think it's a Ferrari. And anyone we ever talk to, like Riley from Envy Auto, he thinks it's a Ferrari. Like, everybody thinks it's a Ferrari.
But this does put out the same kind of energy as a Prowler, right?
Yes. It's dad vibes.
It's the same kind of thing. Like, you get your New Balances out, getting the Prowler, getting the Corvette, let's go.
Yeah. And I didn't really like these headlights at first, but I've kind of gotten over it. It definitely gives it that Corvette vibe when you see it. That's the thing that sets it apart from a Ferrari when you can see it from a distance.
Yeah, you can definitely tell that this is a Corvette, and I think the back end even looks a little bit better as a convertible than a hardtop.
Yeah, I think so too. Especially because we have the Z51 package on this one, we got a little wing.
And then because it's a convertible, we do have a little bit less room in the trunk. Yes, this is mid-engine, so we do have room behind there, but there's still enough room for a carry-on bag. I think they rate it for one golf bag instead of two golf bags.
Yeah, and it is very functional. It's really deep.
And then because of that wing from the Z51 package, pretty much anything you take in and out is going to hit that wing, rest on it. Put some PPF on that, please.
Yeah, 100%. We've been very careful about trying not to hit our bags on it. But while we're talking about stuff back there, the taillights look awesome. They are sequential. And we do have those square exhausts, which again, I'm not really a fan of, just like I wasn't before, but it does sound really good, especially with this convertible top.
So let's listen to it from the outside. And now listen to it from the outside, from the inside.
Yeah, those upshift pops are so good.
very lively exhaust considering how lame a lot of cars are in 2021.
And let's hear this exhaust. Into cliche corner once again. And yeah, it just wants to understeer. Like initially it just wants to plow out, but it's very controllable overall. And let's see if I can get a little bit oversteer. Yeah, a little bit of oversteer if you're careful. I do have the traction in sport because we've determined that that's probably the best one for the roads until you get very used to driving this because of that mid-engine kind of snap oversteer.
Should we play the clip?
Should we?
Yep.
Yeah, I tried to get a little bit more drift angle and turns out I got a lot more drift angle.
Put too much Wu-Tang on that.
A little bit.
But through cliche corner, this compared to that last yellow C7 that was a Z06.
Oh my God.
You're complaining about understeer. Would you rather not have a little bit of understeer before it oversteers compared to just like being on the edge of your seat, pooping your pants the whole time in that C7?
Yeah, that thing was wild. Like it had too much power for the chassis and that wasn't even the ZR1. This is an appropriate amount of power for the chassis and it's actually kind of almost not enough power. So the Z06 is gonna be mental. It's gonna be so perfect.
Yeah, the main thing I remember is when we were in Vegas, we were chasing a last gen ZR1 and it was just so much faster than this.
Yeah.
I felt like, why are you introducing this new model if it's slower? But like, that was a special, special car.
Yeah, that was like lead follow stuff that they like to do.
Yeah.
And part of the Z51 package is also the electronic limited slip differential, so that does help you control the back end a little bit more. And we also have the magneto-rheological suspension, which is lovely. This suspension is so good in every application that we can drive it in.
This car is very comfortable. And then if we're talking about even like comfort by road noise, if you have the top up and the windows up, it's almost silent. Even with the top down, like this isn't a painful car to be in like previous gen Corvettes could be.
Yeah, and daily driving this because of that suspension,
it's too easy.
It's so perfect. Like you put this in tour mode, it's just awesome. I like to use my mode because then I can have everything in like tour, but then the loud exhaust.
Yeah, except for the fact that if you daily drive this, you kind of look crazy.
I mean, not really. You just look kind of special.
This is like if you got this in black or something subtle, or
okay.
Like, or if you got it in white, like the one that they're offering at omaze.com/TSP, then it would be like more normal.
Fair enough.
This is like, this hurts your eyes, this color.
It actually does.
And this is the color that I was trying to get on our first Corvette video that I offered some other journalists like 300 US and I couldn't. That's why I faked the green thumbnail.
Yes.
That green doesn't exist, but this yellowish green does.
And performance wise, this is supposed to do 0-60 miles per hour in 2.9 seconds. However, in a real world scenario, we have not been able to achieve that number. We're not like performance testing this like back to back to back to try and get that number, but just trying to launch this, we're just getting kind of high mid 3 second range.
Yeah, but it does do well every single time for rear drive, but you can definitely feel a bit of slip. I think we found that dry and sport are probably the best. If you're in race or race two, it's just spinning.
And those modes you're mentioning are the PTM traction modes, so the performance traction management, which are a lot of very confusing drive modes. We'll get into that a little bit later when you drive, but let's get you into the driver's seat to experience the convertible side from here.
But the lamest part is when we launch it, there's a performance timer that says accelerate to start, and it literally never starts when you accelerate.
It says accelerate to start.
We
accelerate.
It worked like twice and we didn't know why. Of course now, it actually starts.
Launch control, but with the paddles. Damn, that's quick.
And I didn't miss any gears.
No, you didn't. That shifts quick.
Chilling in drive, let me just floor it.
Such a good amount of power, eh?
It kicks in so quickly. It's perfect if you're in drive and you need to start boogieing.
Yeah, it's the correct amount of power for an old person that may be buying a Corvette. It's not like Z06 levels of power, but this 8-speed dual clutch is amazing. It shifts so quickly. They benchmarked the Porsche 911, and I think they nailed it.
Hey, let me put it into manual. Down. And you get that little snap at the end of every shift.
It's just such an appropriate amount of power.
Into cliche corner, we got sport traction. I feel so much better in this than I did in that last Corvette.
Yeah.
My God.
It just wants to rip.
but it doesn't go full oversteer right away, which I really like.
Yeah, it's very controllable.
It's like a good thing that it understeers before it oversteers.
Which is a characteristic of most mid-engine cars.
The mid-engine cars scare me because I don't really know what they're going to do, so I need more practice before I'm going to start doing crazy drifts on the track.
Yes, and we should probably talk about some weight. Since this isn't convertible, it only adds 77 pounds, which is actually not bad, and you really don't feel it.
I mean, people can go to the gym and get rid of 77 pounds.
That's a lot of pounds to get rid of, though.
There's a lot of people with a lot of extra weight on them.
Yeah, well, I could probably stand to lose 77 pounds. No, that's a lot.
So I'm in manual right now. If I hold the left paddle, is it going to go all the way down to second, do you think?
Let's try it. Yep.
Very good characteristic of this transmission.
And an even better one. Yuri, pull both paddles for me and press the accelerator pedal.
Why aren't I going?
Because you could just do that to rev at people. It's such a good feature.
It's the most perfect thing. Like, you need to be able to rev at people in cool cars. That's a thing. That's like a lot. If someone gives you a thumbs up in your Corvette, you need to legally rev or rip it.
You have to. Otherwise, you gotta sell the car.
And if you're new to our channel and you haven't watched the last Corvette video, maybe subscribe. But in that last video, we went over how you can do burnouts and donuts.
Because it's actually really confusing, but let's just show you some of those clips.
So obviously not the best brake stand car. Donuts are kind of weird, but overall, pretty fun for doing dumb stuff.
Yeah, yeah, it's just...
Not as fun as a front engine older Corvette.
Yeah, it's not a dumb stuff car. It's a go fast car.
Okay, some more go fast things. I really love the lime green matching brake calipers.
Yeah, they are really cool. They are Brembos.
I love how they say Z51 on them. You don't like these wheels.
No, they're just a simple five spoke, which I normally like, but they have these little like notches around it. And when you see the car rolling, it almost looks like it has a bent wheel.
Okay, you know what it reminds me of? The wheels are the 2002 Pontiac Trans Am WS6 in yellow. I think those had black with a silver rim around the edge.
Oh, okay.
So that's why I think I kind of like them. But what would be the Continental recommended tire for the C8?
The Extreme Contact Sport.
I guess a couple more look things for performance. We've got those big side vents on the side. They're very cool, mid-engine stuff.
Yeah, we got scoops for the air. And the problem is, because there's such a big overhang on the doors, getting in and out of tight spaces is really hard because you can't judge where your door is.
Yeah, it's kind of a pain. These need to be updoors. And I photoshopped that in our last video, so check that out.
Yeah, and you actually convinced a lot of people thinking that they were actually updoors, and then a lot of other people stole that clip, re-uploaded it, and tried to make money off of our hard work.
You know what though? I have shared so many memes that if some work that I have done becomes a meme, I am happy.
All right. Yeah, but they re-uploaded and monetized it. That's different.
Whatever, man.
Memes are memes. Re-uploading and stealing content is totally different.
Memes are dreams. Downshift. Whoa! Oh, another look thing that I forgot to mention, the front plate, it has a little attachment for front plates that go on, but I've seen some people just kind of wrap a front plate around on an angle. That looks awful. Do not do that. But in the trunk, we do have like the Corvette attachment that you can clip on if you don't live in a place that requires a front plate.
So now let's talk about this interior, specifically my cramped self in this passenger seat. There's like this great wall of buttons for me, and like, it sucks as a passenger, but again, it's kind of not designed for the passenger.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, the whole area around the driver, the cool cockpit thing. You got a really cool gauge cluster with a squircle steering wheel that makes room so you can see it. Steering wheel, you kind of get used to it, but it's obviously not my favorite.
No, but the paddles are really, really good.
Really, really good. And what's your favorite gauge cluster and head-up display mode?
I just like track mode just because visually it's the easiest to tell when to shift.
Yeah, it's definitely the best for when you actually need to see when to shift, but the sport modes are very nice, all the dials and stuff for normal daily driving, but I do really like how you can get performance stuff on the left. I like to see what my tire temperature is because this thing with cold tires, a little sketch.
Oh, definitely. I like to keep this in normal mode in terms of tire temperature.
Our infotainment screen is angled towards us, which is really nice. We've got a volume knob, which is awesome. We've got a home button where you hold that, that'll toggle between CarPlay and your home screen, which is perfect.
Yeah, and it's all standard GM elsewhere. You can customize everything. You can get into your drive modes if you hit your mode selector, which is a little bit of a weird thing. But then if you go into your Z mode, which is on your steering wheel, that then controls your performance traction with your same mode dial.
Yeah, so if you're trying to do launch control, just double click the Z mode, put the mode to sport, race, dry, whatever, and then you can do launch controls because you can't do it in normal traction control.
That's right.
And then you can also hold the traction button until it turns everything off, which is something that you can't do through your performance traction modes.
Yeah, and getting into the performance traction modes is very confusing by pressing the traction button. You can't like double press it at the right speed.
Yeah, don't bother. Everything through your Z mode if you buy one of these. And then other cool things we have up here.
If you can buy one of these, otherwise you gotta enter for a chance to win one at omaze.com/TSP.
Okay, other cool things. We've got a front camera button up here, which is really nice. And we've got like two angles and a lot of good stuff We can see straight down. It's good for not putting this thing into a curb.
And generally, this interior has so many crazy shapes and like levels to it. It looks very spaceship and like really difficult to clean. Like this leather up here, there's like angles and stuff. It looks like getting a rag under there is basically impossible.
It has gotten very dusty since we've been driving it top down. But this color, nothing special. It's all black. We looked at a lot of really cool different color options when we were in Vegas. However, the nice thing is there's no glare reflection from the colors, which we found in a lot of the other cooler colors.
Right, and then we also have these yellow seat belts, which totally do not match the yellow exterior. Yeah.
Come on, guys, like, it's such a cool color, like, match it up, but whatever, I don't mind it. We forgot the cup test and the visor test.
And then this mash of buttons down the center for your climate just still gives me anxiety.
But you get used to it.
You do, but it's still just, I don't like it.
And these seats are pretty comfortable. Do you like them?
Yeah, considering they're like race buckets, they're not too buckety, so you can still daily this. They're very good.
And then we do have a phone holder between the seats, which is pretty cool.
And then we have Corvette Stingray back here with the waterfall design, which is a speaker, and the speakers and the sound system are very good. There's so much bass.
And then a couple other cool things. This does have a performance drive recorder, so you can put an SD card in and get a whole bunch of cool track information with video overlays, which makes it like the best of both worlds, dailying it and tracking it.
So with that one extra thing that we talked about, I think we're actually done with this car now.
Okay, let's get to the price.
It starts at $78,398.
Canadian.
And this one's optioned out to $111,363.
So would you get the convertible or would you get the hardtop?
I think I'd go hardtop. I do like the shape of this, but to save the extra money,
I would go 100% convertible, but there's nothing wrong with the hardtop because you can also target top it and put that away.
Exactly, that's why I really like it.
And then the real thing is, would you actually get one or can you actually get one?
Unfortunately, you can't. They're pretty much sold out everywhere, like we said earlier.
If you have a Corvette on order, let us know in the comments below what the spec is. If you've got yellow, big shout out to you.
And if you couldn't buy one, it's a good thing you can enter for your chance to win a Corvette Stingray C8 if you go to omaze.com/TSP and enter now. The best part is every donation supports the work of the 500 Festival.